Hey, this is Max here, and in this tutorial you will learn everything about lead scoring inside ActiveCampaign. It's a really cool tool to see which leads are engaged and which ones are not, and then you can take certain actions based on that. So let's dive right in. So what is lead scoring? So the goal of lead scoring is to determine who is ready to buy and who needs further nurturing. So we're going to add points for certain behavior, and the total amount of points will tell you how engaged they are with your business. So if they are hot leads. And this is also called implicit scoring. So when we basically score someone's behavior, like their engagement, and not explicit scoring, that's more about demographics, like maybe where someone is coming from or maybe what their job title is. So this tutorial is all about implicit scoring, where we're going to score behavior. So we're going to add points for certain actions. And a question that I got often asked is, okay, which like actions do we add points for basically? And how many points do you give then? So this is my answer. It is not a science. You can obviously just change this to your own needs, but this is what I almost always use. So I always score when someone is opening an email, then I give 1 point. When someone clicks a link inside an email, then I give 5 points. When someone replies to an email, it's like really good. Then we give 10 points. When someone visits a sales page or a checkout page, then both add 20 points. And when someone becomes a customer, then we give 100 points. And what's also important, I also wrote it in here, is that these points also expire after a certain period of time. So I like to use 6 months, because imagine someone joins your list now, they're really engaged, they open all the emails, they click links, they visit your website, they reply to emails, and then suddenly, boom, they're not interested anymore. And then they still have like a really high like engagement score basically. And then 8 months later, they are not necessarily still engaged because maybe they already haven't opened any emails for like a really, really long time. So that's why you also want to make your points expire basically. And I do this for everything except for when people become a customer, then they will just be 100 forever basically. You can also set that to 1 year if you like, or you could also score separate product purchases. I've also seen some people do that. Now, when is someone then a hot lead? So we're adding points, we're adding points, we're adding points. But at which point are they basically ready to buy? Like, when are they like a hot lead? So I don't really have a real answer to this. Like, it really depends a bit on your business. And I know that most marketers, and it's also what I recommend, start at a threshold of 100. So when people reach 100 points, they're like super engaged with your business, they're hot leads. And then what I recommend you to do is just like look what happens, when do people actually buy your product or service, and then adjust from there. So maybe your sweet spot is like a threshold of 85, or it could also be 160. So yeah, I do not have a real answer here, but like what I would recommend if you're just starting out with lead scoring, start at 100 and then adjust it lower or maybe higher from there. Now, then we're going to actually implement all this. So we're going to create some automations to increase the lead score. So we're going to create separate automations for all these different things basically. And then I want to show you how you can start an automation when someone reaches your threshold. So let's go over to ActiveCampaign. Then we'll first show you how you can set up a new lead score. So what you want to do is you want to go over to contacts and then to manage scoring. Then in manage scoring, you see that I have a lead score that's called engagement score, because we are scoring people their engagement. So to do this, to create this, you have to click add a score, and then you want to do contact score. And then we wait till this is loaded, and then you can give it like a name, give it or like a description. So I'm going to call this then engagement score. I'll call it like 2, and then you can give it a little description if you want. And then you have to set up like at least one rule for this to work. So to do this, we're going to click add a new rule. It's a little bit hidden, but you have to click that text. And then what I will do is I will just add one point when someone subscribes to my main list. So we're going to click save. And then we're going to say add 1 point. So this way we can like save it and then we can also make it active. We are not going to set up all our other rules in here. We really have to create separate automations for it, because as it says here, all the rules that are in here will only run once for each contact. So we have to use automations to add or subtract repeating point values. And that's what we want to do. Like every time someone opens an email, we want to start that automation again and again and again. So this is how you set this up. You set it to save, or you don't set it, you just click save. And then you also make it active and then click save again. And then when we go back to manage scoring, you'll see now that we have like two fields here basically. So I'm going to delete this one because yeah, I already have one. And then we're going over to our automations. So as you see here, I already created 6 different automations, and I want to start with the one when someone opens an email. And then you see that I already have set it up. So every time someone reads an email or basically opens the email, this automation will start, and then we're going to add 2 points to their engagement score. So to do this, you add a new trigger when you create a new automation, and then you just click here, open, reads an email, continue, opens a campaign, any email, the person is in any list. And then this is very important that you set it to multiple times. So this tells you how often the automation will run when this happens. So we want the automation to start every time an email is opened. So we set it to multiple times, and then we click add start, and then the automation will start. Now I will delete it so we don't have any double ones. And then to add points to your contact score, I will delete this and then we'll show you how to do that. You have to go to contacts, and then here all the way at the bottom, you see adjust a contact score. So you go there, you select your score, and then what you want to do. So we said for opening an email, we will add 1 point, right? So we will say add 1 point, and the point should expire after 6 months, click save. And then we end the automation, and then you have to make it active, and then it will work. Now all the other automations are pretty similar, so I'm not going to create them all again and again and again. So here you see how to measure link clicks, like when someone clicks a link in any email, any list, any link, multiple times, the automation will start, and then we add 5 points to their engagement score, and we exit the automation. So all of these are all the same, except for visiting a sales page and visiting a checkout page. So let me open those, because in those we are increasing their engagement score quite fast. So to set this up, like you see here, that we have used site tracking. So when someone is visiting a page, like a landing page in my case, and all my landing pages I know start with a P and then a forward slash. And then I used a wildcard, so like this little star, so that every page that starts with this will trigger. So you've maybe set this up differently, or all your sales pages have like different names, so then you can also add multiple triggers if you want. But I know that mine all start with this. And then what I wanted to do is, because we add so many points, I did not want to add too many points if someone is, for example, refreshing the page or looking at the page again 3 minutes later or 5 minutes later or 10 minutes later. Like I wanted to make sure that people only, like that their engagement score gets increased by 20 only when they did not visit the page already very recently. So to do this, you see that here, that this automation will start when someone is visiting any of my sales pages. And then this is very important, that they're not currently in the automation. And that's this automation. You see here the name is like the same one. So that's what this 1 hour wait is for. So as soon as someone is visiting that page, their lead score gets increased. We will wait for 1 hour and then they will exit. So in that 1 hour, this person will not start this automation again and again and again, because it would be really crap if someone is refreshing the page 3 times and then ActiveCampaign is like, hey, this person visited the page 3 times, and then 60 points are added. I think that's a bit silly. So this is something that I do. I know that other people don't do this, but just feel free to like basically play around with this, because this is what I would recommend. Now, and then you see here with checkout pages set up exactly the same. So all my checkout pages start with checkout. Then I added a wildcard so that all my checkout pages that it will trigger for that. And then I check if people are not currently already in this automation. We add 20 points, we wait 1 hour so that people, if they refresh the page, for example, or come back to the same page 10 minutes later, that we do not increase their lead score again and again and again. Now, then we have another one for becoming a customer, also slightly different. So here I've set up two lists, a main list and a customer list. So I know that if someone becomes a customer, they will come to my customer list. And then this one I've set to only run once, because someone can only become a customer once. And then the automation will start. We add 100 points. And then you see here that these points will never expire. If you want them to expire after 1 year, then you can also really, really easily do that. Now, then I want to show you what you can do based on this. So their lead score is increasing and increasing and increasing. And then at some point you want to do something with that. And I really like to automate that also. So what you can do is you can, for example, start an automation in which you invite someone for a free coaching call. Or you could start an evergreen promotion, or you could maybe notify yourself or someone from your team. So let me show you how to do that. So when we go over to automations, I want to create a new automation, and then I will quickly show you how you can add that as a trigger to the automation. And then I want to show you some other automations that I already created. So to start an automation based on someone's lead score, we have to add a start trigger. And the start trigger is score changes. So we click continue, and then you see here which score. Now we have one that's called engagement score. And then when it changes to be above or below a certain number, you can run the automation. So I want to start this automation when someone reaches a lead score of 100. So I would say when it changes to be above 99, so that's 100, then this will start. And now then you can set it to multiple times or one time. It depends a bit on what you're using this for, but most often you probably use once. So once, and then you could say, okay, we are going to wait until their current time on the context time zone is, for example, here 1 p.m. And then you can start maybe an automation or an email where you say like, hey, you wanna join, me for a coaching call. Now, something like that. So that's one of the things that you can do, but this is how you trigger an automation based on when someone's lead score changes. Now, then another example that I have is an evergreen promotion. So let's go over to automations, and then you can see that we also start that one the same way. So here it is, evergreen promotion. And then you see that we trigger this automation when someone's lead score changes to above 100. Now, I just said that it should be 100, so this should be changed to above 99. It will run once, and then a whole evergreen promotion will start. Like, we wait until 10 in the morning, then we tell them about our upcoming promotion, then we wait until midnight, then we start deadline funnel, because we do not want to trick people with like evergreen promotions that are not real. But with like a tool like deadline funnel, you can add countdown timers to your emails, but also a script to your sales pages and checkout pages that are about the promotion, so that after, in this case, 3 days, you can automatically redirect it to a page that tells you that the offer actually expired. So you're not like tricking people here. This is like a real evergreen promotion. And then you tell people that the promotion is starting now. Cool story. Last day, the promotion is valid. Your questions answered. And then last chance. Now, if you want to maybe also want to notify yourself here, or maybe here in the coaching call, you could also here send a notification email to yourself. So you could say, okay, this email is from an automation and I want to send it to tim@mostcolumbia.com. Imagine that Tim is someone from my team, whatever. And then we can just say like, okay, reached a lead score of 100. And then you can also, and then you have to include like a message. Click add. And then you also get notified. So yeah, I think that's all pretty cool. So I hope that this helped you to understand how lead scoring works in ActiveCampaign. I think it's like a really cool tool to see who is like, yeah, basically ready to buy, who needs further nurturing so that you can like build your whole funnel around that. The next tutorial is also really cool. It's about ActiveCampaign engagement tracking, so you can track when someone engaged with your content for the last time. It's also really, really useful to send, for example, a re-engagement campaign, or maybe even to like throw them off your list when you see that they didn't engage with your content for very long anymore. So if you enjoyed this tutorial, give it a little thumbs up. It really helps me a lot. And make sure to hit that subscribe button when you want to see more tutorials like this.